Okay, all of you tell me, how many steps are there to calculate metal variances? Two steps. Name the two steps. Computation table, variance calculation. Computation table has got how many columns? Three columns. First column, SQ into SP. Second column, AQ into AP. Third column, AQ into SP. Variance calculation, the center, the main variance is called as material cost variance. What is the formula? 1 minus 2. It is broken into two, or two breakups. Material price variance, material usage variance. What is price variance? 3 minus 2. What is usage variance? 1 minus 3. This is the calculation. SQ means what? Standard quantity of raw material for the actual output. What is AQ? Actual quantity of raw material. What is SP? Standard purchase price. What is AP? Actual purchase price. Everybody having the clarity or not? Now, we'll do question number 1 to understand what all this is about. Can I start or not? Now, take question number 1 in the workbook. Please take question number 1. Chapter is full of common sense, nothing great. Read normally, don't put too much pressure on reading the question. All numbers are easy and simple to understand. Can you start or not? No. The following data please full silence. Can you proceed? No. The following data are available for a product. Standard material cost per unit of output 2 kgs at 20 per kg. During the period, the actual details are as under. Actual output produced 10,000 units. Material used 22,000 kgs. Actual price per kg 25 rupees. Find out the material variances. That's a question which has been given. Can we start now? We will not go deep into the logic and all. First, given this question, if you are like a computer, how you'll do it? Okay, without any thinking, we'll see how to do the answer. Once we complete the sum, we'll elaborately discuss the meaning of each and every number as well as the variances. Now, our first objective is to solve the question using the format, right or not? Now, so now my question is, there is one raw material or mix of raw material to produce. One raw material. That is a raw material which is in kgs, which are used to produce what? A finished units. Is that in what? Units. Respond. Yes or no? No. The budget says to produce every unit of finished product, to produce what? To produce every unit of finished product, you should consume how many kgs? How many kgs? 2 kgs. Your purchase manager should purchase at how much rupees per kg? 20 rupees per kg. So they fix the budget for consumption and then what? Purchase price. Okay. How much can you consume for every unit? 2 kgs. And how much you can pay for every kg? 20 rupees. This is coming from the budget, which we call a standard cost. Everybody is on whom? And actually, I have produced how many units? 10,000 units. Consuming how many kgs? 22,000 kgs. And what is the actual price? 25 rupees, which I paid to purchase it. Now they said calculate what? Material variances. Everybody, can you start or not? Now, no need to copy. Just tell me, I'll put the numbers. Okay, tell me what the first step? What the first step here? Computation table. First step is what? Computation table. How many columns are there? Three columns. Can you tell me the three columns? SQ into SP. AQ into A, AQ into SP. This should never change it. Can I put it? SQ into SP, AQ into AP, AQ into SP. Now, understand that all the sums, SP will be given, AQ will be given, AP will be given. The villain is SQ only. That's what I'm saying. Always, who is the villain for metal variance? SQ. That only we should be computing. Remaining are all taken from the question and putting into the format. That's all. In any problem, if we have a difficulty in calculating variance, the difficulty comes only from what? Standard quantity calculation. Everybody, right or not? Now, let's put the known numbers and then go for the unknown. Tell me, what is actual quantity? Varbuga bariya, question, what actual quantity, how many kgs?
22,000 kg.
I purchased at how much price?
25.
AQNT, APS, 22,000 kgs into 25, accept it or not? Enneya, suliya, no. Next, once again, tell me, what is AQ?
22,000 kgs.
Into what is SP?
20 rupees.
22,000 into 20, that second column, third column fully over, enna parita? Now, first column also I know SP, what is SP?
20.
But I have to find out what?
SQ.
Can you elaborate, what is SQ?
Standard quantity of raw material input for what? Actual output.
Everybody understood or not? Now, always I calculate SQ using standard input output ratio, using what ratio?
Standard input output ratio.
Now, this total is written, 22,000 into 25 gives you 5,50,000, 22,000 into 20 gives you what? 4,40,000, that is written. Now, I am going to calculate what?
SQ.
Very simple, input, output. Input is raw material, output is what?
Finished goods.
Tell me what the budget says, how many kgs input for one unit of output?
2 kgs allowed for one unit,
yes or no? No. How many units I produced? How many I produced here?
10,000.
This is called as what output? Actual output. It's called as what output?
Actual output.
For this 10,000 units, how many kgs allowed?
10,000 into 2 gives you what? 20,000 kgs allowed.
That's one. It's unknown. The budget says, if you produce one unit, I will allow how many kgs?
2 kgs.
You said, I produce how many units?
10,000.
How many kg allowed?
20,000 kgs.
That's one. It's unknown. So, what is this 20,000 kg? It is a standard quantity for what output?
Actual output.
Respond. Is on a standard quantity for what output?
Actual output.
Is what is the calculation of SQ? Please tell me yes or no. No. I'll put here what into what? Please. Everybody what into what?
20,000 into 20.
Give so much here?
4 lakhs.
Everybody understanding it or not? Now. So column 1 is how much rupees?
4 lakhs.
Column 2 is
5,50,000.
And column 3 is what?
4,40,000.
Metal cost variance is 1 minus 2. Yes or no? What is 1 minus 2?
4 lakhs minus 5,50,000.
What is the number? Plus or minus?
Minus.
Minus na adverse. Plus means what? Favorable. Minus 1,40,000 means what? 1,50,000 adverse. Is metal cost variance 1 minus 2? Yes or no? Branch it into 2. What are 2 branches?
Material price variance, material UC variance.
What is price variance?
3 minus 2.
What is 3 minus 2?
4,40,000 minus 5,50,000,
1,10,000 adverse. What is the UC variance?
1 minus 3.
What is 1 minus 3?
4 lakh minus 4,40,000 gives you 40,000 adverse.
Is the metal variances calculation. We have not discussed anything. We will feel comfortable after I go for the discussion. Everybody understanding it or not? Now, just we filled up the numbers on the problem and completed the solution. That's all. Are you following up? Now, please, just for the sake of clarity, tell me. Now, we are going to solve this sum. You should tell me every number. I should hear the numbers from everybody. Okay, now how many steps are that? How many steps are that? Yeah, 2 steps. And the standard quantities are working now. How many steps are that?
2 steps.
What is step 1? How many columns? First column.
AQ into AP. AQ into SP.
In which, what is AQ? What is AQ? Are the numbers only?
22,000 kgs.
In what is the actual price? What is AQ?
22,000 kgs.
What the standard price? And here I have to find out what the standard quantity. What columns I should be having?
Input output.
Always SQ found out using input output ratio. Tell me for one unit output, how many kgs input?
2 kgs allowed for one unit.
For 10,000 units, how many kgs allowed?
20,000 kgs.
Tell me what the first column here?
20,000 into 20.
Is it going to how much?
4 lakh.
Tell me what the metal cost variance? What is the number?
1,50,000 adverse.
Branch it into
2.
What is the first branch?
Price variance.
What is the formula?
3 minus 2.
Number?
1,10,000 adverse.
What is the UC variance? What is the number?
40,000 adverse.
That's all. The problem is completed. Everybody understanding it or not? Now, please copy this before you go for the next stage. Now, write question number 1. Question number 1. In that step 1, computation table. Question 1, in that right step 1, computation table.
Step 1, computation table. You copy the computation table, then write working note. What is the working note? Computation of SQ. And in that SQ 20,000 kgs came or not? How it came? Through this computation. In that write working note, computation of SQ. In the working note, write computation of SQ. Finish copying, huh? Everybody finish copying above? Yes, those who are not copy, raise your hand. Can I proceed on? Now, step 2, variance calculation. Step 2, variance calculation. Step 2 is variance calculation. Variance calculation. In the center write material cost variance. Please write in the center material cost variance. 1 minus 2. Center write material cost variance 1 minus 2. Tell me what is the number? 150,000 adverse. 1 minus 2. Number write as 150,000 adverse. Please branch it into 2. Cost variance, branch it into 2. Name the 2 branches. First branch is what? Material price variance. Material price variance. 3 minus 2. Second branch is material usage variance. 1 minus 3. Material price variance. 3 minus 2. Material usage variance. 1 minus 3. Material usage variance 1 minus 3. Everybody, can I proceed up? Tell me what is 3 minus 2 price variance? I want the number. What is the number? 1,10,000 adverse. 1,10,000 adverse. 1,10,000 adverse. What is usage variance 1 minus 3? 40,000 adverse. Usage variance 1 minus 3, 40,000 adverse. 40,000 adverse. Now, with this we have completed the calculation of the variances. 3 stages you have crossed. 1 is copying, number 2 is what? By hearting, 3rd is what? Solving. The 4th and important stage is understanding what is being now discussed. Everybody, can we start or not? Now. Now only my work start. I have to make you understand what we are doing, what are these variances representing, and who is responsible for these variances. Okay. Everybody, can we start or not? Now, I will discuss and then give you the notes. I will not give you notes for each and every sum. Every variance, first time when I discuss about a variance, I'll give you the notes. But the remaining problems will not be having the notes except any new issue has been discussed. Can I start or not? Now, let's start with the discussion. See. The company produced how many units?
சொல்லுப்பா, how many units they have? 10,000 units. They produce 10,000 units, right or not? For the production of 10,000 units of finished goods, they have spent how much for raw material? 5,50,000. கடப்பா, now, to produce this 10,000 units of output, they spend how much rupees? 5,50,000. This is the actual cost of raw material spent. கடப்பா, in the cost sheet, how much is written here? 5,50,000. I spent 5,50,000 rupees on raw material to produce what? 10,000 units of finished goods. Respond, yes or no? To produce 10,000 units, spending raw material, labor, overheads, etc. I am going by stage by stage. Now I am only looking at the material cost. Like they will be looking at labor cost, overheads in the later stages. Everybody, yes or no? Now, to produce this 10,000 units, how much has been spent? How 5,50,000 is spent? Because I consume, how many kgs? 22,000 kg. By paying how much purchase price? 25 rupee. I spent 5,50,000 rupees raw material cost to produce this 10,000 units. Respond, yes or no? The question that arises is this spending okay or not? Is it overspending? Is it underspending or correctly spent? Everybody, are you following the question or not? I have spent 5,50,000. Is it overspending or underspending or rightly spent? Question arises na? For that, the next question is, how much I should have spent? I have spent how much? 5,50,000. The next question is, sir, how much I should have spent? Yes or no? To produce this 10,000 units, how much I should have spent? Are you all following what I am saying? Very simple. The budget says, the target is, every unit you should have consumed. How many kgs? 2 kgs. For my output of 10,000 units, I should have consumed how many kgs? 20,000 kg. So the quantity I should have consumed is how many kgs? 20,000. And my purchase manager should have purchased how much rupees? Yeah, 20 rupees. That means I should have spent 4 lakh rupees for the raw material. I have spent how much rupees? 5,50,000. Have overspent, underspent, correctly spent? Overspent means it is good or bad. Bad means what? Adverse. Hence the material variance is 1,50,000 adverse. Everybody, yes or no? This year the factory is having an adverse material variance. So how much rupees here? 1,50,000. Because has overspent 1,50,000. Everybody, yes or no? So the column 1 is called as standard cost. And the column 2 is called as what? Actual cost. Standard cost, how much rupees? 4 lakh. What actual cost? 5,50,000. Standard cost is called as cost allowed. It is called as what? Cost allowed. What is column 2? Cost spent. The difference between cost allowed and cost spent is called as what? Cost variance. Everybody, yes or no? Now, before discussing further, I want to clarify one thing. Is this 4 lakh rupees standard cost or budgeted cost? It is standard cost. It is not budgeted cost because this is the budgeted cost for actual output. Everybody, yes or no? The 10,000 units is what output? Actual output. Now, this point, just to have you more clarity, I'll explain in further detail and then proceed. Everybody, can I proceed or not? Now, this is not budgeted cost. 4 lakhs is not what? Budgeted cost. 4 lakh is what? Standard cost. Now, to make you understand, I'll include one extra detail and then make explain the concept. Okay, now, what is my actual output? 10,000 units. Now, suppose at the beginning of the year, my budget output is 15,000. Can I keep it or not? My budget output, how many units here? 15,000 units. Now, look at this. I add a detail called as what? Budget and output is how many units? 15,000 units. See. There is something called as budgeted cost. Katapa? See, budgeted output is equal to how many units? 15,000 units. That means budgeted quantity is equal to every unit. The budget is how many kgs? 2 kgs. In the how many units? 15,000 gives how many kgs? 30,000 kgs. Respond is on whom? And the standard price is how much rupees per kg? 20 per kg. Are you following not? Now I'll tell you, budgeted cost is equal to what into what? 30,000 kgs into much? 20. What the budgeted cost? 6 lakhs. Okay. Now somebody says the budgeted cost is 6 lakhs, the actual cost is only 5,50,000.
What should be second column, equity appear, no, the budgeted cost is what, 6 lakhs, and the actual cost is what, 5 lakh 50, very good company, they saved a cost of what, 50,000, will you accept or not? Because this is the cost, when I produce how many units? 15,000, I produce only what, 10,000, I cannot compare the 6 lakhs with what, 5 lakh 50, because this is the target cost of 15,000 units, that the actual cost spent for what? 10,000 units, it cannot be compared, yes or no? That is why I don't want budgeted cost, I always only want to watch standard cost. I want only what cost, yes, standard cost. What is standard cost? It is also budgeted cost only, but the output is for what? Actual output, everybody, yes or no? Now, when I revise a budget, I call as what cost? Okay, can you tell me standard cost, what output? Actual output is equal to how many units? 10,000. Then I call this as budgeted quantity or standard quantity? Standard quantity. And a budgeted quantity is budgeted quantity for budgeted output. Standard quantity is what? Budgeted quantity for actual output. Everybody, yes or no? Still I'm in budget only. In what budget? Flexible budget. I prepare for the actual output. Everybody, able to distinguish or not? No. In this case, tell me what is standard quantity? 2 kgs. This is budget actual. Budget into how many units? 10,000. This budget actually actual. That gives how many kgs? 20,000 kgs. If the kg plan, this kg allowed. Are you finding distinction or not? No. And then what is the standard price here? It is 20 per kg. When somebody asks you to find out standard cost, it is 20 into what? 20,000. That gives how much here? 4 lakhs. In other words, for my 10,000 units, I'm allowed to spend how much? 4 lakh. I spend how much? 4 lakh 50. Hence, 1 lakh 50 adverse variance. Respond is or no? Now, tell me, I'm comparing budgeted cost and actual cost. Standard cost and actual cost. Standard cost and actual cost. Everybody, are you understanding it or not? In the point, clarity, it is the same logic only for labor, variable, and then what? Fixed overhead variance. In cost variance, never I compare budget and actual. I compare only what? Standard and actual. Standard is also what? Budget. For what output? Actual output. Everybody, this point, are you having the clarity or not? No. I'll give this as a notes in the later stage. Can I continue with my discussion? No. Come to the discussion. Simple English only. Tell me, what is column 1? Standard cost. Then tell me in English, what is standard cost? Cost allowed. The material cost allowed for my production is how much? 4 lakh. For my output, I'm allowed to spend 4 lakh. I have spent. I have overspent, underspent, overspent. 1 lakh 50 adverse. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Understand that the standard costing is a postmortem. After everything has happened, we do the postmortem, right or not? This is purely a postmortem exercise. Okay, no. We calculate 1,50,000 variance, put in dustbin. Somebody should be made responsible for it. Right? Favorable, na, somebody should be rewarded. Adverse means somebody should be what? Punished. Everybody, yes or no? No. When something is favorable, everybody says, I only did it. Yes or no? Adverse, some people say, he only did it. Right or not? In that case, we should have a clarity. Who is responsible for this 1,50,000 adverse? Right? Any correct? No. So 1,50,000 overspent. Who is responsible? Question arises now. That we have to analyze it further. Why this adverse 1,50,000 arise? Are you following what I'm saying? Now, tell me, why the material cost will increase? Tell me the 2 reasons. Material, raw material cost increase. Tell me 2 reasons why the cost has increased. Either the purchase price has increased or the amount consumed increased. So no. Either the increase in cost may be due to the increase in purchase price or may be due to what? The increase in consumption of raw material. So no. If the adverse variance is due to the purchase price, the purchase manager is responsible. So no. If it's due to the extra consumption, who is responsible? Production manager should be responsible, right or not? So, I should analyze further into what? Price variance, usage variance, to fix the responsibility. Everybody, yes or no? Now tell me, why the raw material cost changes? Because the raw material price may change or the raw material consumption may change. I may pay higher price, hence the variance can be what? Adverse. I may consume more, hence the variance can be what? Adverse. It may be due to price, it may be due to what usage. I have to break it into further two. Everybody understanding it or not? Can I say? Now let's go for the analysis. Now, what is the formula for price variance? Sollupa, what is the formula for price variance? 3 minus 2. Very simple. Column 3, column 2, is there or not? The difference between column 3 and 2 is due to quantity or price? Another quantity is what? Say, what is difference is only what? Price. And 3 minus 2 is price variance. Yes or no? Can you correct that? Now, to put it more simply, I plan to purchase at 20. I purchased how much rupees here? 25. I paid extra or less? Extra. How much rupees? 5 rupees extra purchase price. For how many kgs? 22,000. The price variance is 110,000 adverse. Yes or no?
Yes,
tell me, price variance, what's the formula? 3 minus 2. 3 and 2, quantity same or different?
Same.
Price is same or different?
Same.
Hey, this is called as what variance? Price variance. Inna parida not now. Next is what variance? Usage. Tell me the formula.
1 minus
3. Column 1 and 3, the price is same or different?
Same.
This is also 20, that is also what? 20. The quantity is same or different?
Different.
I am allowed to consume 20. I consume 22,000. Over usage, under usage, over usage. How many kgs? 2,000 kg. At how much rupees? 20 rupees. 40,000 adverse. Respond, yes or no? So the difference between 3 and 2 is the price. The difference between 1 and 3 is what? Quantity. The difference between 1 and 2 is price and quantity. Yes or no?
Yes,
column 1 and column 2. What difference between column 1 and column 2? SQ and AQ. As well as what? SP and AP. So 1 and 2 varies because of what? Quantity and then what? Price. We see price alone, it is what? 3 and 2. We see quantity alone is going to be what? 1 and 2. We have the price variance and what? You say variance. In the second stage of discussion, everybody, are you following what I am saying? Now tell me, price variance. How much rupees I should have paid? 20. How much I paid? 25. Every kg was excess payment? 5 rupees. For how many kgs? 2,20,000. What the price variance? 1,10,000. How many kgs I am allowed to consume? 20,000. How much I have consumed? 22,000. What the extra consumption? 2,000. You know how much rupees? 20. What the adverse variance? 40,000. And 1 minus 2 gives you the total variances. Everybody understanding it or not? With this, we have completed the price variance and usage variance discussion also. One more issue needs to be discussed. I'll discuss that at the end of the notes. Can I proceed or not? No. Up to this, metal variances calculation. Are you following?
No.
Before I go into the notes, let's have an overall view and then proceed. Tell me, company produced how many units? Are the actual. How many units here? 10,000 units. For this 10,000 units, it should have spent how much rupees? 4 lakh. It has spent how much rupees? So column 1 is should have spent. Column 2 is what? Has spent. Yes or no? It should have spent how much? 4 lakh. And has spent how much? 5 lakh 50. It is overspent or underspent?
Overspent.
How much raw material cost overspent? 1,50,000 adverse. Point number 1 over. Yes or no? Why the raw material cost is overspent? Probably the price has been extra paid or the usage has been extra. Respond, yes or no? When you look at the price, I call us what variance? Price variance. Tell me what price I paid? 25. What I should have paid? 20. I overpaid or underpaid? Overpaid. How much? For how many kgs? What the variance of price? 1,10,000 adverse. Next. I have consumed how many kgs? 22. I should have consumed 20. Over under consumption, over usage. How much it is? 2,000. You know how much rupees? 20. Gives you what? 40,000 adverse. Cumulatively, we are getting the raw material variances. Are you able to understand or not?
No.
Write down notes. Write down notes. Point number 1. So I am giving you notes because when you revise, you should be able to independently understand what has been discussed. Okay. This I will not be giving for each and every sum. No need to do in the examination also write the notes, but only for your understanding's sake. Everybody, can we start or not? Write down notes. Point number 1. The company produced. The company produced 10,000 units. The company produced 10,000 units. By spending, the company produced 10,000 units by spending how much rupees? 5,50,000 rupees. The company produced 10,000 units by spending 5,50,000 rupees towards raw material cost. Company produced 10,000 units by spending ₹5,50,000 towards raw material cost. Can I proceed? Point number two. For the above output, it should have consumed, how many kgs? 20,000 kgs. For the above output, it should have consumed 20,000 kgs. Are you following? For the 10,000 units, it should have consumed 20,000 kgs. At a purchase price of, it should have consumed 20,000 kgs at a purchase price of, how much rupees? 20. It should have consumed 20,000 kgs at a purchase price of 20. That is, the cost allowed is, how much rupees? 4 lakhs. That is, the cost allowed is 4 lakhs. The cost allowed is 4 lakhs. So tell me, for 10,000 units, how much rupees allowed here? 4 lakhs. Point number 2 or 3? 3. Actually, it consumed, how many kgs? 22,000 kgs. Actually, it consumed 22,000 kgs. By purchasing it at, actually it consumed 22,000 kgs. By purchasing it at how much rupees? 25. Actually it consumed 22,000 kgs by purchasing at 25. That is, the cost spent is, 5,50,000. Everybody having the clarity or not? Next. Point number 2 or 3? Okay, point number 4. Don't laugh. Here's not a section number to remember. Yes or no? No, point number 4. Since the cost spent is more than, the cost allowed, there is an adverse raw material cost variance. How much? 1,50,000. This is due to, continue writing, this is due to two reasons. Branched into two. Can tell me the two reasons here? Change in. First reason is what? Change in purchase price. Second branch is change in consumption. Change in purchase price and change in consumption. Change in purchase price, put down here, I can draw it. Excess price of, resulting in
excess price of how much per kg? 5 per kg, resulting in excess price of 5 per kg for 22,000 kgs. Resulting in excess price of 5 per kg for 22,000 kg, which is how much? 1,10,000 adverse. Which is 1,10,000 adverse. Which is 1,10,000 adverse. Which is 1,10,000 adverse. Same point, you once again put the domain control. Purchase manager is responsible for it. Who is responsible? Purchase manager is responsible for it. Purchase manager is responsible for it. Now, procurement is a separate specialized department. They should take the responsibility for higher price. Purchase manager is responsible for it. Purchase manager is responsible for it. Everybody understanding up. Go to the second branch. What is the second branch here? Change in consumption. Put a domain control. Allowed to consume 20,000 kgs. Allowed to consume 20,000 kgs, but consumed 22,000 kgs. Allowed to consume 20,000 kgs, but consume 22,000 kgs. But consume 22,000 kgs. Thus, there is an over usage of there is an over usage of how many kgs? 2,000 kgs. Thus, there is an over usage of 2,000 kgs. There is an over usage of 2,000 kgs. Again, put the down again, right? Production manager responsible. Thus, there is an over usage of 2,000 kgs. Put the down again, right? Production manager responsible. Production manager responsible. Production manager responsible. Are you all able to understand or not? Now, up to this, the discussion is almost completed. One more point I'll just discuss. Just to have more clarity or some confusion may arise, I'll discuss that and then go for the next sum. Okay, now, see. The first question is, price variance is 3 minus 2. Accepted?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? No. I am asked to purchase at how much rupees? 20. I purchase how much rupees? Yeah, 25. And what is the extra? 5 rupees. Kadapa. For how many kgs? 22,000 kg. It is 1,10,000 adverse. Respond. Yes or no? The difference in price, I multiply by the actual quantity. Number right or not?
Yeah.
Because for 22,000 kgs purchase, he paid how much rupees extra? 5 rupees extra. 1,10,000 is clear cut.
Yes,
but when it comes to usage variance, tell me, I have used how many kgs? 22. But I should have only used how much? 20,000. 2,000 overuse. Kadaba. When I want to make it into money, I consume 2,000 kg extra, that's not over. You say, how much extra? 2,000 kg extra. Somebody ask you, please tell me in rupee term, how much rupees you have spent extra. Then I multiply by what price? Standard price 20. Why not actual price 25? Question arises na?
Yes,
yes or no? Because 2,000 kg extra consumed or not? This 2,000 kg which I consume extra, I spend 20 rupees or 25, yeah, 25. It have been 50,000 adverse, not 40,000. Question, Purunjaba? Are you all following what I am saying? In other words, when I calculate that usage variance, the difference in usage, I multiply by the standard price or not by what? Actual price. Why the question arises? Are you all following the question? Now, I'll tell you the reason. The reason is, 2,000 kg production manager extra consumed. That is the only fault of his. 5 rupees extra paid is not his business. It is the business of the purchase manager. Are you following what I am saying? No. If I multiply by the actual price, then the efficiency or inefficiency of the purchase manager will color the evaluation of the production manager. Are you following?
Did you understand it or not? No. See, when I say 50,000, his mistake is only 40,000. That 10,000 mistake of what? The purchase manager, everybody so know, he cannot be made to take responsibility for 50,000 adverse. And but only for how much adverse? 40,000 adverse. Everybody, are you all follow what I am saying? So, the difference in quantity only is the mistake of the production manager. And it should be under only by efficient price of what? 20. If I use an actual price, it may be more or less. More or less is only due to what? Purchase manager efficiency and inefficiency. When I evaluate production manager, I cannot bring the efficiency and inefficiency of what purchase manager for his evaluation. Hence, I use what standard price. Point number one. Everybody, follow what I'm saying. So now tell me the 2000 kg difference. Column 1 minus 3, the 2000 is multiplied by actual price or standard price? The standard price. The reason I said is what? I cannot multiply by actual price because if I use actual price, the efficiency, inefficiency of the purchase manager gets into what? Evaluation of the production manager. Hence I use a standard price. Point number one, understood or not?
Yes, sir.
No. Then you may ask the next question. Sir, the same logic for purchase manager also. What about? Because 3 minus 2, I should have paid 20. I have paid what? 25. 5 rupees extra I paid. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Had the production manager rightly used, it have been only 20,000. Na?
Yes,
so the remaining 2,000 is overusage. So when I multiply by actual quantity, you put the question back to me saying that, sir, now we are using what? Actual quantity. Is the evaluation of person, purchase manager, is it not influenced by what? The production manager inefficiency or efficiency? Question arises back. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. In that case, the simple question is, when I calculate the usage variance, the difference in usage is multiplied by what? Standard price. When I calculate price variance, the difference in price is multiplied by what? Actual quantity. So why does the inconsistency in what? Both these approaches. Are you following what I am saying? Now, here is understand the work properly. Understand what? Work properly. What is the work of the purchase manager? To purchase standard quantity, any quantity order. His work is to purchase any quantity order. I am asking to purchase 1 kg or 1 lakh kg. His duty is to purchase at 20 rupees per kg, any quantity order, not the standard quantity order. Yes or no? Upon 22,000 kg itself, you should purchase at what? 20 rupees only. You cannot say he consume more. I won't take responsibility because consumption different. You are asked to purchase how many kgs? You are asked to purchase how many kgs? 20,000. I gave you work for 22,000 kgs or not? When I gave you the work for 22,000 kg, you should have purchased all 22,000 kg. How much rupees? Yeah, 20. You paid how much? 25. The 5 rupees extra you paid for all the quantity purchased, that is also your work only. You cannot escape it. Are you following what I am saying? But we cannot say this for production manager because production manager is responsible only for what? You say he cannot have any control of the purchase price. Are you following what I am saying? So the logic cannot be applied similarly for what? Purchase manager and production manager. Purchase manager should take responsibility not for standard quantity but for what? The entire quantity purchase. Yes or no? But the production manager can respond only for the quantity and not for what price. You know, the roles are different. Everybody, are you following what I am saying? So that means this calculation is what consistent with the practical approach. Are you following? That is why I did not use the actual price in usage variance because the actual price brings what inefficiency of purchase manager into production manager say evaluation, which I don't want. But when I come to purchase manager, I take what actual quantity because his work itself is what purchase actual quantity. He cannot blame it on production manager. So no. Now, the production manager may consume 20,000 kgs or 250,000 kgs, anything. Whatever I ask you, should be purchasing. So, no, your duty is to purchase at what? 20 rupees, any quantity ordered. Everybody understand what I am saying? In that case, this right in saying that the variance is 110,000 adverse. Are you fine what I am saying? Now, there's another point I just wanted to highlight it because you may get confused. Sir, why for usage alone I use what? Standard price. Why for purchase price I use what? The actual quantity. The question may arise. This is the reason for what using such calculations. Any opportunity? No. With this, we complete the discussion about the first term called as material cost variances. This point, notes not required, only for you to understand it, not related to the examination calculation. Can I proceed or not? No. With this, the price, the material variances have been completed. Now, லெட் அஸ் கன்சாலிடேட் அண்ட் தென் கோ ஃபார் த நெக்ஸ்ட் சம். ஸோ மச் ஹாஸ் பீன் டிஸ்கஸ்னா, ஸோ வெரி லிட்டில் ஒன்லி கான்செப்ட் பட் த டைம் டேக்கன் இஸ் வாட் டூ மச். ஓகே, நவ் டெல் மீ மெட்டீரியல் வேரியன்சஸ் வி ஆர் நாட் டிஸ்கஸிங் அபவுட் சிங்கிள் ரா மெட்டீரியல் இன்புட். கடமா டெல் மீ ஹவு மெனி ஸ்டெப்ஸ் ஆர் தேர், ஹவு மெனி ஸ்டெப்ஸ் ஆர் தேர், டூ ஸ்டெப்ஸ், நேம் த டூ ஸ்டெப்ஸ், கம்படேஷன் டேபிள், வேரியன்ஸ் கால்குலேஷன், ஹவு மெனி காலம்ஸ் ஆர் தேர் இன் கம்படேஷன் டேபிள், நேம் த த்ரீ காலம், எஸ்கியூ இன்டு எஸ்பி, ஏக்யூ இன்டு ஏபி, ஏக்யூ இன்டு எஸ்பி. வாட் இஸ் எஸ்கியூ? Of raw material input for actual output. We always calculate using how many column? Two column. What are two columns here? Input output ratio. Can I present or not? Now, what is SP? What is AP? What is AQ? Actual quantity of raw materials. Now tell me the main variance, cost variance. What is the formula? 1 minus 2. Branches into? What are two branches? Price variance, usage variance. What are price variance? 3 minus 2. Usage is 1 minus 3. It has been elaborated, discussed using a small sum. Question number 1. Everybody understanding it or not?
Yes, sir.
Can I go to the next stage? Now, let's go to the next stage. Give the heading. Material cost variances. Mix of raw materials. Material cost variances, mix of raw materials. Okay. Same pattern. First, I want to take the format. Then you are going to by heart it. Then we'll be doing a problem and then we'll be understanding the concept. Okay, now. Step 1, computation table. Step 1, computation table. Step 1, computation table. Okay. Earlier, don't write anything. Earlier, how many columns were there? Now only one more extra column. There'll be how many columns here? Four columns. First three columns same. First three column what? Same. One extra column, that's all. Respond. Can I ever say? No. Please write. What is column 1? All of you tell and write. What is column 1? SQ into SP. No change. Right. What is column 2? AQ into AP. No change. What is column 3? AQ into SP. That also has not changed. AQ into SP. Column 4 is RAQ into SP. Column 4 is what? RAQ into SP. Study material uses RSQ. Give the name what? RSQ. For the classroom, I give the name RAQ. It is more easily understandable. Are you following what I am saying? Now, if you go and look at the study material, they will be using that as what? RSQ. R, now, we are using in the classroom as what? RAQ. Can I say it? Write down. Where? I don't want to discuss once again SQSP and all, waste of ink and page. So no, no, I have to discuss only about what? RAQ. Where RAQ means, right, where RAQ means revised actual quantity. Continue writing. Where RAQ means revised actual quantity. Where RAQ means revised actual quantity. Full stop. It is... Full stop and continue writing. It is actual quantity in. It is actual quantity in standard mix. 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 Study material refers it as. We call as RAQ, na? Study material refers it as RSQ. Study material refers it as RSQ. Study material refers it as RSQ. In bracket, la, revised standard quantity. I call it as revised actual quantity. They call it as what? Revised standard quantity. Ours is easily understandable, hence I give this name. Okay, revised standard quantity. Study material refers it as RSQ, bracket, revised standard quantity. Revised standard quantity. Don't worry now what it is all about, we'll be discussing later. Leave it. Can I put it or not? Now, step one over, what is step one? Computation table. Next is what? Step two, variance calculation. Step two, variance calculation. Step two, variance calculation. Okay. Variance calculation. Everything already you know it. In center, what variance? Material cost variance. 1 minus 2. Center, material cost variance. 1 minus 2. Branch it into 2. What are 2 branches? Material price variance. 3 minus 2. Material usage variance. 1 minus 3. Up to this already known. Get up, material cost variance 1 minus 2, price variance 3 minus 2, usage variance is 1 minus 3. Finish writing up now. Only small breakup. Usage variance is further broken into 2. If further broken into what? 2. First branch, write material mix variance. First branch, material mix variance 4 minus 3. Material mix variance 4 minus 3. Second branch is material yield variance 1 minus 4. Material mix variance 4 minus 3. Material yield variance 1 minus 4. Material yield variance 1 minus 4. Material yield variance 1 minus 4. Now, everybody, have you all finished writing this or not? Now, with this we have completed the format for the metal variance with mix of raw materials. Okay, that's all. Now, tell me one by one. I am going to use one raw material or mix of raw material. In such case, let us see the format. How many steps are there? As usual, 2 steps. What is the first step? Computation table. 3 columns or 4 columns? Tell me the 4 columns. SQ into SP, AQ into AP, AQ into SP, RAQ into SP. In the first 3 columns, old or new? What the new column? RAQ into SP, 4th column. What is RAQ? Revised actual quantity. What is that? Actual quantity in standard mix. Other important. What is RAQ? Actual quantity in standard mix. Study metal cost has what? RSQ. Next, tell me the variance. What is the main variance? Material cost variance. Formula? Broken into? What are 2 variances? Price variance, usage variance. What are price variance? Usage. Usage broken into? What are 2 variances? Mix variance, yield variance. What is the mix variance? 4 minus 3. Yield is what? 1 minus. Very simple. Always a breakup should give the total or not. Now, 4 minus 3 plus 1 minus 4. 4 and 4 gets what? Cancel. Becomes 1 minus 3. Get up. 1 minus 3 plus 3 minus 2. What gets cancelled? 3 and 3. It becomes what? 1 minus 2. Everybody, are you understanding it or not? Now, that's how the variances are calculated. Now, can you go for a problem or not? Now, let's go for the question number 3. Take question number 3. That deals about mix and yield variance. Okay. Question number 2, I will come back after I complete 3. Take question number 3. Please, shh. Can we start? Those who understood the discussion till now made in this chapter, raise your hand. Okay. Those are all going to be awake further, raise your hand. Others are going to sleep. Or answers only. Can I go see? No. Those have intention to listen calmly without talking, raise your hand. Shall I proceed? No. Okay. See, this problem 90% is same as the last one. It is 90% as what? Last one. Except for a few extra calculation, that's all. Everybody, can I start or not? No. Understand that once a complete material variance, ditto same what? Labor variance, the small changes is going to happen, that's it. Everybody, can I proceed or not? Now, let's start with our discussion, please. Standard set for a chemical mixture of a firm is as under. A, B, 40%, 60% standard mix, standard price per kg 20, 30. The standard loss in production is 10%. During a period, the actual consumption and price paid for a good output of 189 kgs are A, B, quantity 90, 110, actual price 1834. Calculate material variances. That's a question which has been asked. Everybody, can we start or not? Now, see, you are going to tell me the calculations. How many steps are there? Two steps. Step one is what? Three columns or four columns? Why four columns? And material A and B is mixed to produce a finished goods. Yes or no?
Yes,
so we are using a single metal, mixer metal. Immediately when you see multiple raw material, one should go for how many columns here? Four columns. Everybody, yes or no? Now, we can straight away start putting the numbers. Can I say now? Can you tell me the four columns? All of you have four columns here? SQ into SP, AQ into AP, AQ into SP, RAQ into SP. Point number one, yes or no? What are two raw materials? A and then B. Okay, now, always the villain is what? Villain is what? SQ. And RAQ is not as difficult as SQ, but it should also be what? Compute that. So, SQ and RAQ only we should compute. The remaining numbers are given by what? Question itself. Respond, yes or no? Now, let's put the known numbers and calculate what? Unknown. Tell me, standard price of A and B, you know what? Don't know what? No. A and B standard price, you know it or not?
Yes.
What is standard price of A and B? 20 and 30. Something into 20, something into 30.
Yes.
The something calculate what? Later. Can I say? Now tell me, AQ and AP, what the actual quantity of A and B consume? 90 kgs and 110. What the actual price? 18 and 34. Are you looking at the word book or not? Tell me what into what and what into what? 90 kgs into 18, 110 kgs into 34. Yes or no? Now come to the third branch. AQ into SP. Tell me what it is. 90 kgs into 20, 110 kgs into 30. Yes or no? Now I know RAQ or not? No. But I know SP or not? Yes. Tell me what it is here. Something into 20, something into 30. Everybody, yes or no? Now, that may have to only calculate two numbers. If I know SQ and RAQ, problem over. Everybody, yes or no?
Yes.
So always, computations are simple. It won't take more than 2 minutes to solve a variance. Are you following what I'm saying? The explanation only is long, but the answer is very small. Can I say or not? Now, so my aim is now calculate what? SQ and then what? RAQ. Two villains. Who is the main villain? SQ. RAQ is very simple. SQ is only what? The main thing. Are you following what I am saying? Now, in that case, total, I don't know. Tell me 90 into 18 plus 110 into 34. What the actual cost of raw materials? Calculate idea. Put back. Take the calculator. Tell me 90 into 18 plus 110 into 34. Very simple. I purchased 90 kgs of A at 18, 110 kgs of B at how much? 34. How much I totally spent for raw material? 5360. At least tell me this. What's the number here? 5100. This I will put question mark. Everybody, yes or no? Now I can fill up all the four columns. Once I complete one, SQ and RAQ. SQ alone is somewhat more logical to calculate. RAQ is very simple. Can you solve with SQ or not? Now, what is SQ? Standard quantity of input allowed for what output? Actual output. Everybody understood or not? Now, for this, you have to go to the budget to know the standard input output ratio, right or not? Now, look at this. All of you participate, input output. If you look at the question said standard loss in production is 10%. What standard loss here? 10%. Because in number of processors, When I put 100 kg, entire 100 will not come out. What happens here? There's a processing loss of what? Some percentage which you call as normal loss. More about that, I'll discuss in process costing later. Brother Baba, we'll be having one separate class to discuss about normal loss and abnormal loss before entering into the process costing chapter. At that time, we'll learn it. But understand that what I put into the machine need not come out because there can be a process loss that is possible. Respond. Yes or no? No. The budget says that when I put 100 kg into a machine, can I expect 100 or less than 100 or less than 100? There's an expected loss, a standard loss. How much percent? 10%. So the budget says that your input of 100 should give an output of 90. Input 100. Now what should be output here? 90. What happened to 10? Loss during the production. Respond. Yes or no? This happens in most of the industry, okay, where the processing loss what is naturally bound to happen. Everybody, yes or no? So the budget says for 100 input, you should be having how much output? 90. Tell me how many kgs I actually produced. The good output is how many kgs? 180 I have produced. Should I put 189? More than 189? More than 189. How much should I be the input? 189 divided by 90 into 100. What the kg allowed here? 210. Everybody understood or not?
Yes,
should I repeat?
Yes,
those want to repeat, raise your hand. I'll repeat it once again. I know that you wouldn't have understood it. Okay, now. Don't talk. See. What is SQ? Standard quantity for actual output. We should know the first standard. We should first know what standard. The standard says there is a standard loss of 10%. Standard loss of how much percent? 10%. That means the budget says if you put 100, you should get 90. What the budget says what? If you put 100, you should get what? 90. So the budgeted input output ratio is 100 is to 90. Tell me, how many kgs, good kgs I produced? How much came out? 189. If 189 came on, now how much I should have put in here? 189, more than 189, more than 189. Budget says that for 90 you can put what? 100. So for 189, how much I can put here? 210 I can put. Yes or no? Now that means the budget says that you are allowed to put what? 210 kgs to produce a 189 kg to have a standard loss of 10%. Respond. Yes or no? Okay, now my question is, this 210 kg is of A or B or A and B?
A.
Because I don't use a single, I use what? Mix. The student should be comprising of what? A and B. 50-50, yeah? Again, budget says that your standard mix is what? 40-60. The student should be having what? 40% of A and then what? 60% of B. That should be what? 84A and 126B. Everybody, are you following what I'm saying? In other words, how many kgs of finished goods you produce? Now, first 1, 2, 3 start. Are you following? Tungadiya, wake up. Can I say, how many kgs you produced? How many you produced? Yeah? 189 kgs. By actually putting how many kgs? 90 of A, 110 of B. Question barba. Correct. I produce 189 kgs. I produce what? 189 kgs. Look at the work and tell me by putting actually how much? 90 A, 110 B. Yes or no? But as per the budget, I'm allowed to put what? 84A and 126B. Put it up. Everybody, yes or no? No. Again, I say, actual output, how many kgs? 189 kgs. To produce 189 kg, what I have actually used? 90A, 110B. What I should have used? 84A, 126B. Respond, are you having the clarity or not? So this is a standard quantity. How I got 84, 126? Very simple. At the beginning of the day, they said that for every 100 kg, you should get how much? 90 kg. Since I got how much? 189. I should have put how many kgs? 210. The 210 is of A and B? No. A and B together. In what ratio? 40-60 standard may. It should have been 84A and 126B. Everybody understood or not? No. I just wrote 84 and 126 here. Column 1 also fully complete, right? What the only pending thing is what? RA. RAQ, rumba simple. But RAQ means it's actual quantity, na? It's actual quantity. What makes the standard mix? Very simple. What is actual quantity? 90 and 110. 200 kg actual quantity. 200 kg is actual quantity and this 90 and 110 is actual mix. Adapa. If this 200 kg in what? Standard mix. 40, 60. It becomes what? RAQ. Everybody understood or not? Now tell me, what is RAQ? Actual quantity in what mix? Yeah, standard mix. Okay, tell me. What is actual quantity? Once again, tell me. 200 kg. 110 of A, 90 of what? B. I put into the machine's mouth. How many kgs? 200 kg. If it is a standard mix, A and B should be in what ratio? 40, 60, 80 and 120. Yes or no? So 80 and 120 is actual quantity in standard mix. 90 and 110 is what? Actual quantity in actual mix. Everybody, are you all following what I am saying? So what is RAQ? Actual quantity in standard mix. Any approach? Now. Don't ask me why I am calculating. All this will be explained at the later stage. I am just only explaining what? Calculation. Everybody understood or not? Now. So with this, the entire table has been calculated. Enappa purinjuda? Now. I will ask you the question one by one. Just quantity alone, you tell me. SQ there, AQ there, RAQ there. Three quantities are not? Now. What is SQ? Standard quantity in standard mix. What is AQ? Actual quantity in actual mix. What is RAQ? Actual quantity in standard mix. Enappa right or not? No. In that, how I calculated SQ alone is tricky issue. Now, how much is the input output allowed? Tell me. 100 input, 90 should be the output. For 189 output, what should have been the input? 210 kgs. This is the standard quantity for what output? Actual output. I may put more than 210, less than 210, a different issue. But I should have put how much? 210. Of A, B or A and B. A and B. In what mix? Yeah, standard mix. Either metal allowed in standard mix. Everybody, yes or no? And one more thing, what I calculate is what? RAQ. I first calculated actual quantity and divided in what? Standard mix. I got the RAQ. Respond. Are you following or not? No. That's all. All the four columns are filled up. Tell me, what are metal cost variance? 1 minus 2. Tungadi, what a cost variance? 1 minus 2. Tell me, what is 1 minus 2? 5460 minus 5360, what's the number? 100 favorable. Now, cost variance branches into two. Name the two branches. Price variance, usage variance. What is the price variance formula? 3 minus 2. What is 3 minus 2? 260 adverse. Usage is what? 1 minus 3. What is 1 minus 3? 360 favorable. Yes or no? The usage further branches into what? Mix and yield. Mix means is what? 4 minus 3. What is 4 minus 3? 100 favorable. And what is yield? 1 minus 4. What is 1 minus 4? 260 favorable. That's how you should calculate the variances. Yes or no? Now, we'll be having a more logical discussion once we complete the copying now. I want you to only understand one thing. How to calculate SQ? How to calculate what? RAQ. Remaining are all not at all an issue. Tell me, have you all understood the SQ calculation in this sum or not?
Yes, sir.
RAQ?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now please copy the slide. Okay, write question number. Please write question number 3. Write question number 3. Question number 3. Step 1. Computation table. Step 1, computation table. Copy this first, then I'll give you two working notes. One for SQ, another for RAQ. All of you, next time when you come, bring a pot and keep. 3 hours, how many bottles you'll be drinking? Finish copying, huh?
Don't talk, please. Stop talking, please. Shall I proceed? Working out number one. Those who have not copied, raise your hand. Let's copy fast. Shh. Stop talking, please. Shh. Okay. Working out number one. Calculation of SQ. Finish copying, please. Shall I proceed now? Working out number two, RAQ. Stop talking, please. Finish copying up. Finished, huh? What's happening? I've come copy quickly. Finish copying or not? No. Simply 200 kg divided in the ratio of 40%, 60%, 80, 120. Please don't draw the boxes, 3D shapes. Don't draw. Just write only the numbers. Don't do coloring. Can I proceed? No. Completed, now. Okay. This has been already copied. Don't copy once again. Can you see? Now. Step two. Write down step two. Variance calculation. Please, all of you, let's do it together. Step two, variance calculation. Step two, variance calculation. Variance calculation. Center right. Material cost variance, bracket love 1 minus 2. In center right, material cost variance, in bracket right, 1 minus 2. Can you tell me what is that 1 minus 2? 100 favorable. Material cost variance, in bracket 1 minus 2, right, how much? 100 favorable. 100 favorable. Branch that into 2, branch that into 2, what are 2? Breakups, material price variance 3 minus 2. Material price variance 3 minus 2. Material usage variance 1 minus 3. material price variance 3 minus 2, material usage variance 1 minus 3. What is price variance 3 minus 2? Tell me, what's the number? 260 adverse. Price variance is 260 adverse. Usage 1 minus 3, what it is?
360
favorable. Usage 1 minus 3, 360 favorable. Usage branch it into 2. Metal usage branch it into 2. What are 2 branches? Material mix variance. First branch is material mix variance. Second branch, material yield variance. Material mix variance. Second branch is material yield variance. Material mix variance. Material yield variance. Mix is what? 4 minus 3. Yield is 1 minus 4. Mix is 4 minus 3. Yield is 1 minus 4. What is 4 minus 3? Tell me. 100 favorable. What is 1 minus 4? 260 adverse. Correct? Huh? 260 favorable. 1 minus 4 is 260 favorable. 260 favorable. Now, we have completed the solution to this particular problem, but we should know what is mixed variance and yield variance, right or not? With that, the metal variance will be completed. Can we start or not? Now, see. I have produced how many kgs? Answer my question. Please. Straight. Narrow karpa. Say straight, all of you. Okay. Now, tell me. I have produced how many kgs? How many kgs? 189 kgs. I have produced 189 kgs for which I should have spent how much rupees? 5,460. I have spent how much? 5,360. I am starting from the beginning, metal variance onwards. Okay. I have produced 189 kg. For my actual output of 189 kg, I should have spent how much for raw material? 5,460. But I have spent only how much? 5,360. I have overspent, underspent, or correctly spent. Underspent. I have saved raw material cost. How much rupees? Yeah, 100 rupees. And the metal variance is 100 favorable. Respond. Yes or no?
Yes,
why the material cost varies? Because of the price. Because of what? Usage. We know the logic. For price, what the price variance? 3 minus 2. And what the difference between 3 and 2 is quantity. Yeah, price. Price. You know, the difference is between SP and AP. And the 3 and 2 is what? Price variance. In that case, I should have purchased at 20. I purchased at what? 80. That's a favorable variance for A. But I should have purchased at what? 30. I purchased for what? 34. Then adverse variance of what? B. Overall, it results in what? A net adverse variance. Point number 2. Everybody understood or not? It may also be due to what? Usage. I should have used 84,126. I have used what? 90,110. Due to usage also what? It varies.
Yes, sir.
So 1 minus 3 is what? Usage variance. So the metal cost varies due to the price change or due to what? The consumption change is already discussed in the previous sum. In this sum, we're going to go more detail into how the usage has changed. How the usage has what changed, which we overclassify into what? Mix and then what? Yield variance. Can I go to the next stage?
Yes,
now, the first question is, sir, what is mixed variance? What is what? Yield variance. I'll discuss and then give you the notes for those 2 points alone. Can I proceed or not? Now, see. Let's start with the mixed. Start with what? Mixed variance. See. I am supplying milk to all your house. For example, Achyapa. Don't laugh, yeah. Rajinikan, right? No. I am supplying milk to what? All your houses. Okay. Now, see, normally what is there inside milk? Milk and water. What is that? Yeah? Milk and water. Mix. Gadapa. Wait. Shh. See, standard mix is Dharmapadi, that is a good person, you should be having 90% milk, 10% water should be mixed and supplied to you. So no?
Yes, sir.
One liter should be having what? 90% milk and then what? 10% water. Now without water, it cannot be. It should be having what? Some diluting effort. So 90% milk, 10% water is a standard mix. Respond, yes or no? I want to become crorepati. I want to become what? Crorepati. Example, okay. In that case, what I do is, I change the mix. 90% water and then what? 10% milk. 1 liter supply, no change in quantity. Quantity is what? Same only. Only thing is what? I just change the mix. 90 water and then what? 10 milk. I can save my cost or not? Yes, sir. Assuming water is cheaper than milk. Now, in that case, it is going to be saved, right or not? This is called as mixed variance. What variance? Yeah? Mixed variance, where the quantity remains same, but still I can overspend or underspend by just changing what? The mix. It is called as what variance? Mixed variance. I use more of a cheaper raw material and less of what? Costly raw material. It will be resulting in a favorable mixed variance, and ulta will be resulting in what? Adverse mixed variance. Are you following the concept of mix or not? Because when I mix two products to produce a final product, by changing the mix, I can overspend or underspend the cost, which we can say mixed variance. Point number one. Are you following? Let's understand in much more detail what happens in this particular sum. Okay, tell me. Mixed variance, what's the formula? What's the formula? 4 minus 3. What's the mixed variance formula? 4 minus 3. Column 4 minus column 3. Now answer my question. Column 4 and column 3, the number is same or different? Okay. 4 and 3 is different due to price. You know, both are what price? Standard price. Column 4 and 3 is due to quantity?
Yes,
no. Both are what? Same. Both are actual quantity. Yes or no? Can I proceed? Should I repeat once again? Now, I'll start from the beginning. Now, please, listen. What is mixed variance? 4 minus 3. Difference between column 4 and 3 is due to price. Why? Both are standard price. Difference between 4 and 3 is due to quantity. No. You know, both are actual quantity. In a column 4 also 200 kg, column 3 also what? 200 kg. It is not due to price, both are SPs. It is not due to what? Quantity, both are AQs. It is due to what? Mix. In a column 4 is actual quantity and standard mix. Column 3 is what? Actual quantity and actual mix. So the difference between 4 and 3 is not price. The difference between 4 and 3 is not what? Quantity. The difference is what? Mix. Hence 4 minus 3 is called as what variance? Mix variance. Everybody, are you understanding it or not?
Yes,
now, very simple. In our case, mix is favorable or adverse?
Favorable.
How much favorable? You may wonder why it is favorable. Very simple. Yeah? I put 200 kg into the machine. As per the standard, A should be 80 and B should be 120. I put actually 200 kg. Had I put using the standard mix, it should be 80A, 120B. Yes or no? But how much I put? 90A and 120B. In other words, I put 10 kgs of A extra. I cut what? 10 kgs of B less. Yes or no? In that case, I use more of A and what? Less of B in my production. Yes or no? A is having how much price? 20. B, what the price here? 30. I use more of a cheaper raw material. I use what? Less of a costly raw material. I change the mix and had a variance of what? 100 or something favorable. Everybody, are you understanding it or not? No. It can even become what? Adverse. If I use more of B and what? Less of A, it can become adverse. Yes or no? That means, instead of using 80A, I use what? 90A. Instead of using 120B, I use what? 110B. In other words, I use more of A and what? Less of B. I use more cheaper raw material and less costly raw material, resulting in a favorable mixed variance. Everybody, are you understanding the concept of mixed variance or not? Okay. Now tell me, what is the formula for mixed variance? 4 minus 3. Difference between column 4 and 3. Is it price?
No.
Both are?
Same.
What? Both are standard price. Is it due to quantity?
No.
No. Why? Both are? Actual quantity. It is due to what?
Mix.
What is column 4? Actual quantity, standard mix. What is column 3? Actual quantity, actual mix. Hence 4 minus 3 is called as what variance? Mixed variance. Point number 1. Everybody understanding it or not? No. The next variance is what variance? yield variance.
Let us understand that and I'll give you the consolidated notes for both together. Now next we'll discuss what variance?
Yield variance.
Okay. Now, what is the formula for yield variance?
1 minus 4.
I'll explain in two angles. I'll explain how many angles here? Two angles. Okay. Yield is what?
1 minus 4.
Column 1 and 4 is a difference price. Huh? Because both are what?
Standard price.
Is a different mixer. Huh? You know, column 1 is standard quantity and standard mix. Column 4 is what?
Actual quantity and standard mix.
This is also 40-60, that is also what? 40-60 ratio. So no. So column 1 and 4 is not price. Column 1 and 4 is not what?
Mix.
Column 1 and 4 is quantity. It is what?
Quantity.
Column 1 is 210 kgs and column 4 is what?
200 kg.
This puny to what?
Quantity,
which I call as yield variance. Respond is or no? Rumba simple. When I use something, two things here. How much quantity I use, in what mix I use. When look at the quantity, I call as what?
Yield.
Look at mix, I call as what?
Mix.
Both together, I call as what? Usage variance. Everybody understanding it or not? Now, I'll just make you understand much more elaborately. See, for my 189 kgs of output, how many kgs output here? 189 kgs output. The budget says you can put how much into the machine?
210.
I put only how many kgs?
210.
So how many kgs I put here?
200.
10 kgs saved or not? That means I use less quantity or not, my yield is more. Put it up. Are you following what I'm saying? So for a 189 kgs of output, I'm allowed to put how many kgs?
210 kgs.
I have put how many kgs?
200 kgs.
So I have put more quantity, less quantity, less quantity. With less input, I got what?
More output.
And the yield is increasing or not? It becomes what variance here? Yield variance. One way of understanding it. Are you following? Yes, or no?
No.
Another way is much more better way to understand it. I'll now explain this. See. As per the standard, I should have put how much input?
210.
I get how much output? 189. My loss is how much here?
21 kg.
Is it accept or not? Now the expected loss is how much percent?
10%.
How many kgs here?
21 kg.
You want to have a loss in percentage. I expect to lose what?
21 kgs.
How many kg input?
210.
The standard loss is 10%. Yes or no? In other words, my yield is how much percent?
90%.
RL fund is the budget. So no. The budget, as per the budget, for my 189, I should have put how many kgs?
210.
And what allowed loss here? 21 kgs. And the 21 kg means how much percent? 10% loss is allowed. My target yield is 90%. Now, what happened? Actual. Tell you what happened?
Actual.
Actually, I input how many kgs?
200.
And what is my output?
189.
How many kg loss?
11 kg loss.
Tell me what the percentage loss here?
11 divided by 200.
11 divided by 200. What the percentage loss?
5.5%.
Everybody able to understand or not? Now, that means my yield is how much percentage?
94.5%.
Everybody understood or not? That is, I wanted to have a yield of 90%, but the yield became what?
94.5%.
That's a favorable yield or not?
Yes, sir.
I expected to lose 10% during processing. I lost only what? 5.5%. It may be due to good maintenance or machine or the workers working what? More carefully and so on. They have tried to avoid what?
Loss.
They try to eliminate what?
Loss
or reduce the loss due to which my yield has what?
Improved.
That's called as what variance here? Yield variance. Everybody understood or not? Yes or no? Now tell me, yield variance. What is the formula for yield variance?
1 minus 4.
Column 1 and 4, what is same?
Standard price is same.
What is same?
Mix is same.
What differs only what?
Quantity.
The budget says, for your output, you are allowed to put what?
210.
But I have put only what?
200.
That means, I have saved quantity or not?
Yes.
With the lesser input, I am able to achieve what?
Same output.
What I am saying? Why? Because the loss has what?
Reduced.
The yield has what? Improved. Everybody, yes or no? Now, that means the yield is favorable. I targeted to have a 90% yield and a 10% loss, but I achieved what?
Just 5.5%. loss, and what? 94.5% yield. The yield has improved by 4.5%. In money terms, we had what? Yield variance of 160 as some number. Everybody, are you understanding it or not now? Either we call us what variance here? Yield variance. Everybody, yes or no? Now, one last consolidated view, and then give you the notes. Okay, now, tell me, what is usage variance formula? 1 minus 3. All of you carefully, this is going to give you the full picture. What is usage variance formula? 1 minus 3. Now, column 1 and column 3, is the price same or different? Same. 1 minus 3, it is not due to price. Yes,
sir.
It is due to only what? Usage. What is SQ? Standard quantity in standard mix. What is AQ? Actual quantity in actual mix. If I see the mix angle alone, I call as what? Mix variance. If I see the quantity alone, I call as what? Yield variance. If I see both, I call as what? Usage variance. Respond yes or no? Are you all so tell me, why 1 and 3 is different? One is what? SQ in what? Standard mix. What is 3? AQ in actual mix. 1 and 3 is different due to two reasons. One is what? Quantity. And second is what? Mix. 4 minus 3 look at only the mix angle. And 1 minus 3 only at what? Quantity angle. Both gives you what? The usage variance. Everybody, are you all following what I am saying? Either understanding of the usage variance and is break up into mix variance and what? Yield variance. Please tell me, are you understanding it or not? With this, we have completed material variances. Completed what? Material variances. Except for stock of raw material discussion, all the concepts are completed. Please respond. Are you having that clarity or not? No. We have to write the notes for what variance? Mix variance and yield variance. And then we can just go for the next area. Okay. Are you following up? Now, once I complete this notes, I'll do question number 2. A very, very small sum. 3, I'll come and do it later. That is 4, I'll come and do it later. 5, I'll be doing it towards the end with stock of raw material. Then we can move on to the labor variances now straight away. Can we start up? Write down notes. I think you have finished copying up to the variance calculations or not? Write down notes. Point number 1. Point number 1. Understanding mix variance. Point number 1. Understanding mix variance. What's the point number 1? Understanding mix variance. In that right, A. In that right, A. Point A. Mix variance is equal to, understanding mix variance, when I write A, mix variance is equal to column 4 minus column 3. Mix variance is equal to column 4 minus column 3. Point B, the difference between 4 and 3, point number 2, or point B, the difference between 4 and 3, 4 and 3 means what? Column 4 and column 3. The difference between 4 and 3 is not price. The difference between 4 and 3 is not price. Bracket la, both are SPs. The difference between 4 and 3 is not price. In bracket write what? Both are SP, standard price. Bracket close. Come on. Is not quantity. Sentence continues. Is not quantity. The difference between 4 and 3 is not price. Is not quantity. Bracket write what? Both are AQs. Is not quantity. In bracket write what? Both are AQs. Is not quantity, in bracket right, both are AQs, bracket close. But is mix. If you read the sentence continuously, be able to understand what I dictated here. Difference between 4 and 3 is not price, is not quantity, but is mix. Is not price, can I explain in bracket what? Both are SPs. Is not quantity, explain in bracket what? Both are AQs. But is what? Mix. In bracket, right? But is mix. In bracket, right? Column 4 is, in bracket, right? Column 4 is actual quantity in standard mix. Column 4 is AQ in standard mix.
And column 3 is, column 4 is AQN standard mix. And column 3 is AQN actual mix. Column 4 is actual quantity in standard mix. And column 3 is what? AQN actual mix. Actual quantity in actual mix. Bracket close. Bracket close. Can I proceed? Point number, point B or C?
C.
When we use more proportion of cheaper raw materials, when we use more proportion of cheaper raw materials, when we use more proportion of cheaper raw materials, the mix variance will become favorable. When we use more proportion of cheaper raw materials, the mix variance will be favorable. The mix variance will be favorable. And vice versa. The mix variance will be favorable and vice versa. But understand, and vice versa means what? If I use more proportion of costlier raw material, mix variance will become what? Adverse. And vice versa. Everybody understood or not with this? We have completed the mixed variance understanding. Can I push it or not? No. I forgot to tell you one thing. See, normally I can say this problem exception, it is only numbers. Okay. Normally, when the mix is favorable, yield may become adverse. Reason is, if I use more cheap material, less what? Costly material, that's a reduction in quality. There will be more losses during what? Production. If I use more costly material, high quality material, more use, and low quality material, what? Less use, means the products will be what? Much more efficiently produced. The yield may become what? Favorable. Respond, Ariel, follow what I am saying. Now, the reason for an adverse yield may be due to what? Favorable mix variance by opting for a cheaper raw material. Respond, yes or no? Or a reason for an adverse yield, that is favorable yield, may be due to what? Adverse mix where I go for a quality raw material. Everybody understood or not? Now, in this case, both have become what? Favorable. It may happen, but this can also be an interpretation. Can I say? Now, next. Point number 2, understanding yield variance. Point number 2, understanding yield variance. Point number 2, understanding yield variance. Point number 2 is understanding yield variance. Understanding yield variance. Can I say? Point number, in that A, yield variance is equal to, correct, yield variance is equal to column 1 minus column 4. Yield variance is equal to column 1 minus column 4. Yield variance is equal to column 1 minus column 4. Everybody understanding of point B. The difference between 1 and 4, the difference between 1 and 4 is not. The difference between 1 and 4 is not. Is not what? Price. The difference between 1 and 4 is not price. Bracket la both are SPs. The difference between 1 and 4 is not price. In bracket both are SPs. Come on. Is not mix. Is not mix. Back at right one, both are standard mix. Now, one is standard quantity and standard mix. Four is what? Actual quantity and standard mix. And bracket, both are standard mix. Both are standard mix. Bracket close. But is what? The input quantity. But is the input quantity. Okay. Now, continue writing. So, I think I am dictating point B. Now, please. The difference between 1 and 4 is not price. Both are SPs. Is not mix. Both are standard mix. But is the input quantity. Continue writing. Stop talking. Please. Stop talking. But is the input quantity. But is the input quantity? but is the input quantity. In bracket right, column 1 is standard quantity. In bracket right, column 1 is standard quantity and column 4 is actual quantity. Column 1 is standard quantity and column 4 is actual quantity. Standard 1 is column 1 is standard quantity and column 4 is actual quantity. Now, you are creating tension in me because you are talking. Can I see now? So I am not able to talk freely. Okay, now, repush. Next, point B or C?
C.
Point C. Right. Standard. Unlike that. Input 210 kgs. Standard. Input 210 kgs. Output 189 kgs. Input 210 kgs. Output 189 kgs. Loss 21 kgs. Loss 21 kgs. Percentage loss is equal to 21/210. Percentage loss is equal to 21/210 is equal to how much percent? 10%. Percentage loss is equal to 10%. Expected yield is equal to what? Expected is equal to how much? 90%. Expected yield 90%. So the budget wanted to have a 90% yield. Yes or no? I don't. Actual. How much actual input? 200 kgs. Input 200 kgs. Output 189 kgs. Output 189 kgs. Loss 11 kgs. Loss 11 kgs. Percentage loss 11/200 is equal to 5.5%. Percentage loss 11/200 is equal to 5.5%. Actual yield how much percent? 94.5%. Actual yield 94.5%. Okay. Same point you continue. I think you're writing point C, yeah?
Yes,
okay. Same point you continue. For the output of 189 kgs, write down. For the output of 189 kgs, 210 kgs of input allowed. For output of 189 kgs, 210 kgs of input allowed. But the actual input is just how many kgs? 200 kgs. The actual input is just 200 kgs. Full stop. Continue. The loss allowed is 10%. And the loss happened is only. The loss allowed is 10%. And the loss happened is only how much? 5.5%. The loss allowed is 10%. And the loss happened is only 5.5%. And the expected yield is how much percent? 90%. And the expected yield is 90%. But achieved how much? 94.5% yield. The expected yield is only 90%, but achieved 94.5% yield. 94.5% yield. Hence, there is a favorable yield variance. Everybody, are you following or not? Last point. Point number two or three? Point number three. Understanding usage variance. All this will help you in revision process quite easily. Okay, understanding usage variance. Understanding usage variance. Point number one. Usage variance is equal to, please tell me the formula. Usage variance is equal to what? 1 minus 3. Usage variance is equal to 1 minus 3. Usage variance is equal to 1 minus 3. Point B. The difference between 1 and 3 is not price. The difference between 1 and 3 is not price. Both are what? SPs. But the difference between 1 and 3 is not price. Both are SPs. But it is. But it is what? Mix and quantity. Full stop. Point B or C? C. SQ is standard quantity in standard mix. SQ is standard quantity in standard mix. And AQ is what? Actual quantity in actual mix. If we see the mix difference, it is mix variance. If we see the mix difference, it is mix variance. And quantity difference, it is yield variance. Everybody, up to this, are you following or not? With this, we have completed the material variances. One small sum, just we'll be doing it. A past examination question, and then go and do the labor variances. Now, take question number 2. We'll just complete in no time. Very quickly, take question number 2. Okay. In a period, please, 5,460 kgs of material were used. What is 5,460 kgs? Actual quantity of raw material, AQ, at a total standard cost of 23,124. There is nothing but what? SQ into SP. I call us what? Standard cost. Material usage variance is 246 adverse. What was the standard allowed weight? That means standard quantity of material for the period. That's the question. Everybody, can we start or not? No. I will do it and then give you time to copy it. Okay, just a 1 minute problem. Can we start or not? No. Here only formats are very helpful. I think it is question number 2. Okay. They have given you what variance? Thungalapa, please. They have given you what variance? Use variance. Tell me what the formula for use variance. 1 minus 3. What is column 1? SQ into SP. What is column 3? AQ into SP. Everybody, yes or no? No. SQ into SP only we call a standard cost. Tell me what is the total standard cost given? 20? 3,000?
23,124 is the column one. Respond, yes or no? No. And they also given you actual quantity. What the actual quantity given? 5,460 kgs is the actual quantity. Everybody, yes or no? No. Now, let us know the USA variance. What is the variance given? How much adverse? 246 adverse. Now, see, material usage variance is equal to 1 minus 3. Accept data. What do you say variance? 243 adverse. Adverse na plus or minus? Minus. Can I say like this? Minus 246 is equal to 23,124 minus column 3. Minus what? Column 3. Respond. Is or no? We bring it this side. Column 3 is equal to, column 3 is equal to how much? 23,124 plus what? 246. What is column 3? 1%? 23,370. Write as 23,370. 23,370 is column 3 or not? No. What is standard price? 23,370 divided by what? 5,460. Tell me the number. 4.28. Correct them?
Yes, sir.
4.28. I know the standard price as what? 4.28. Everybody understanding it or not? Now, standard price 4.28. What should be standard quantity? 23,124 divided by 4.28. Tell me the number. 5,403. Okay, 5,403 or 2. As a case, I have it as 5,403 kgs is the standard quantity. Other question, what the question here? Standard weight allowed is how much here? 5,403. I am allowed 5,403. I consume how much? 5,460. Due to extra usage, I have how much? 246 adverse usage variant. Can be understood. Everybody understanding it or not? That's a missing figure calculation. In the answer, Purunjida. Now please copy this quickly. Question number 2. Question number MUV means what? Material usage variance. Exam write everything in full. Okay. Also write a standard quantity into standard price. Don't write SQ, SP and all. We write it in the classroom for the convenience sake. Or at least give a expansion of the abbreviations in the examination. Don't write the abbreviations. Okay. To easily remember and quickly do it, we have what? All these short abbreviations use. Better to use the expanded names in the exam. You are not going to do 10 sums, only one sum in the exam for this chapter, right or not? So we can afford to write the full names for all the items. Same way, cost ledger accounting. Don't write SLC account. Don't write what? GLA. Write as what? Stores ledger control account. General ledger adjustment account. In my class, I am doing 14 to 15 sums. It will be long time taken to write everything fully. Hence, we use what? Abbreviation. Exam, write everything in full names. Okay. Now, have you all finished copying it? Huh?
Yes, sir.
Respond, yes or no? No. We have completed question number 1, question number 2, question number 3 in the metal variances. Wait or not?
Yes,
can I proceed? Now,
4 and 5 I'll do later. 5 I will do only after discussing partial single plan. And 4 is a little bit interesting sum. I'll do it once we get the grip over the chapter later. Can I say? Now, 4 and 5 we will do, but I'll come back and do it later.